Good morning, students. As you know that in previous classes we have discussed about power sharing. What was the case of Belgium? You know that in Belgium power was shared between different social groups and conflict was minimized, and it was done through the constitutional amendment. So today in this lecture we will develop our lesson. So let's start from here. The chapter is power sharing. Power should be shared due to moral and prudential reasons. Why we should share the power? Yesterday we had discussed about why we should share the power. So this is a reason we should share the power on the moral concentration, on the moral level. This is the moral responsibility of the individual. They should share the power. Moral as well as prudential also. The term moral here is morality. This is our morality. Our moral values does not allow to do so. So this is the responsibility of the government, the different political parties or different social groups, linguistic groups. They should share the power on the moral value. We will discuss about these things in detail later. Prudential reasons means समझदारी का आधार पर हमारा जो कंसाइंस है, हमारा जो नॉलेज है वो भी कहता है. एक्चुअली यू कैन से दैट लॉफुल, इट्स अ लॉफुल. प्रूडेंशियल रीजन मीन्स लॉफुल. इट्स आवर कंसाइंस, बेसिक नॉलेज एंड आउटकम्स ऑफ पावर शेयरिंग इज गुड. दिस इज द रीजन वी शुड शेयर द पावर. सो आई हैव डिवाइडेड फॉर योर ईजी अंडरस्टैंडिंग. दिस इज द मॉरल रीजन, दिस इज द प्रूडेंशियल रीजन वी विल डिस्कस. It is true spirit of democracy. You know that democracy always says that we should share the power equally among all bodies, individuals. This is the true spirit of democracy. So this is the moral reason we should share the power, because this is the true spirit of democracy. ये लोकतंत्र की आत्मा है और इस वजह से हमें पावर को शेयर करना चाहिए. पावर शेयर करना चाहिए मतलब सत्ता जो है, जो शासन प्रबंध है, जो रूलिंग सिस्टम है, उसको डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करना, उसको एक जगह कंसंट्रेट नहीं करना. वी शुड नॉट ट्राई टू कंसंट्रेट द पावर और टू इंक्रीज सोशल कन्फ्लिक्ट्स. वी हैव टू मिनिमाइज द चांसेस ऑफ वायलेंसेस, राइट्स, कम्युनल वायलेंसेस. हाउ कैन वी कंट्रोल ऑल दीज थिंग्स? वी कैन कंट्रोल दीज थिंग्स थ्रू शेयरिंग द पावर. एज मच एज वी विल बी लिबरल, वी कैन मिनिमाइज द चांसेस ऑफ कन्फ्लिक्ट्स. यू नो that is why in India also power was shared. You know that panchayati raj sarkar, that is the local government, it was the sharing of power, or this is the spirit of democracy. So next, there is need of participation of individuals. Democracy mein hamesha ye baat kahi jati hai ki har ek vyakti ki saajhdari honi chahiye. Informations or any kind of इन्फॉर्मेशन शुड बी शेयर्ड एमंग ऑल. किसी बात को एक जगह छिपा करके नहीं रखना चाहिए, सारे कुछ को ओपन होना चाहिए. आई मीन टू से दैट RTI, यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड थ्रू RTI, राइट टू इन्फॉर्मेशन. वी कैन एक्सेस इन्फॉर्मेशन, व्हाट्स गवर्नमेंट डूइंग. मीडिया कैन ऑल्सो रिवील ऑल द थिंग्स, बट इन स्पाइट ऑफ दैट वी हैव अ लॉ दैट इज कॉल्ड RTI. वी कैन गो थ्रू दिस एंड वी कैन कम टू नो व्हाट इज RTI एंड वी कैन एक्सेस द इन्फॉर्मेशन व्हाट्स government is doing. There is need of participation. How can we ensure the participation of individual or participation of all the people, those who are living in any area? We can ensure through their popular participations in democracy, or this is the moral reason to share the power. Next one is it maintains balance in society. Students, you know that if we do not share the power, there is chances of conflicts, there is chances of disputes among different social groups. If we have to control all these things, we will have to share the power to maintain the balance in society, to get better outcome. So in the prudential reason, it will bring better outcomes. This is our knowledge, this is our conscience. It tells us we should share the power because it will bring better outcome. There is less chances of conflicts, there is no disputes, all problem can be sorted out. It reduces chances of conflict, as I have earlier told you that, in different social groups. It ensures stability. Here is the term stability. Stability means स्थायित्व, कोई भी सरकार जो है कोएलिशन गवर्नमेंट हो या फिर वो मेजोरिटी की गवर्नमेंट हो, उसको स्टेबल होना बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट होता है। किसी भी देश के विकास के लिए, डेवलपमेंट के लिए स्टेबलाइज्ड होना और स्टेबिलिटी की गवर्नमेंट होना बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण। इफ़ आवर गवर्नमेंट विल नॉट बी स्टेबल इन द सेंट्रल और स्टेट और इन लोकल बॉडीज, हाउ कैन वी एक्सपेक्ट? देर इज ऑलवेज पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ फॉलिंग ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, समटाइम्स आवर पोलिटिकल पार्टीज आर अनेबल टू प्रूव देयर मेजोरिटी इन द फ्लोर टेस्ट। सो स्टेबिलिटी इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। हाउ कैन वी इंश्योर? वी कैन इंश्योर स्टेबिलिटी थ्रू शेयरिंग द पावर। देर विल बी नो डिमांड इफ वी कैन फुलफिल ऑल द डिमांड्स इफ वी शेयर द पावर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ लैंग्वेज, कल्चर और डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ रिलीजियन। देर इज नो चांसेस ऑफ कन्फ्लिक्ट। सो दिस इज द मॉरल रीजन, दिस इज द प्रूडेंशियल रीजन। यू कैन सी एंड यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इन बेटर वे। फॉर मोर अपडेट्स एंड फॉर मोर नॉलेज इन्हांसमेंट, यू कैन गो थ्रू द एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक। नेक्स्ट, एज आई हैव अर्लियर टोल्ड यू दैट एथनिक कंपोजिशन ऑफ बेल्जियम, हियर यू कैन सी दैट डच स्पीकर मेजोरिटी इन कंट्री, माइनॉरिटी इन कैपिटल। ब्रसल्स इज द कैपिटल ऑफ बेल्जियम। Brussels is the capital of Belgium. You have to understand here, Dutch is a linguistic group. Dutch people speaks. Dutch is a language, they speaks Dutch language. Dutch speaker majority in country but minority in capital. Mind it. French speaker majority in capital but minority in country. This is what? This is vice versa. This is vice versa, just opposite. Majority in country but minority in capital. Here, majority in capital but minority in country. French speaker, 80% people speak French in Brussels, but they are not majority in country area, they are majority in capital only. Always remember this fact. Dutch speaker are majority in country area but minority in capital. French speaker, majority in capital but minority in country. This is the difference between these two. You have to understand this very carefully. Next, Germans, 1% people speak German. मात्र 1% लोग जर्मन भाषा बोलते हैं, लेकिन इनके साथ भी पावर को शेयर किया गया, इनको भी अपॉर्चुनिटी दिया गया, इनका भी रिप्रेजेंटेशन किया गया, उसके बारे में डिस्कशन आगे करेंगे। नेक्स्ट, टू शेयर पावर with different social or linguistic groups, community government was created through constitutional amendments. In Belgium, here you have seen the ethnic composition. Now, to minimize the conflict, the chances of violences in Belgium, how can we minimize, how can we sort out the problem? If we have any problem, how can we sort out? Here is a solution. To share power with different social or linguistic groups, community government was created. The third one level, earlier Belgium had central government, state government, but next year you can see that community government was created. If someone asks you, what is community government, why it was created, you can answer, this is for social or linguistic groups, and this was created to minimize the chances of conflict, to share the powers, to get better outcomes, to get better results. It was created through constitutional amendments. In Belgium, there were several constitutional amendments during 80s or 90s to get better result. We have also facility in our own constitution to amend at the time of need. As we have amended citizenship amendment bill, you know that we have brought in our own country. We have abrogated Article 370 and 35A in Jammu Kashmir. We have sorted out that issue also. How? We can do this through constitutional amendments. So in Belgium, it was also done through the constitutional amendments. Now Belgium had, now, next, after creating community government, Belgium had central government, state government and community government. In all these three levels of government, every linguistic groups can represent themselves, their representative will be there. There will be equal number of ministers. You can see that equal number of representatives will be chosen from each linguistic group. peer groups. There is no any partiality among themselves. They will be chosen from each linguistic groups. Equal representation should be there. Next, community government can make laws for educational, cultural or language issues. You know that in India also we have central list, we have state list, concurrent list and residuary list. Why this is? This is because each level of government can make laws according to their need. Centralist means the matter which is concerned with the center. Central government can make laws in the parliament, that is Lok Sabha or Raj Sabha. State list, state government is responsible, our state legislature is responsible to make laws on their own subject. Concurrent list means state and central both. Central and state, both the levels of government can make laws on the topics or the subject which is given in the concurrent list. Samvarti suchi. Concurrent list mein jo bhi subject daale gaye hain un par kanun banane ka adhikar, law banane ka adhikar central aur state dono ko hai. For an example, you can see education, divorce, marriage. These are some of the subjects which is the part of concurrent list. Education, marriage, divorce, these are the subjects on which central and state both can make laws. Residuary subjects means computer, software, IT. Central government, only central can make laws on the subject which is given in residuary list. So here states, you have seen power sharing. Power should be shared due to modal and prudential reasons. Modal reason, here you have seen prudential reason, I have discussed. Next one is ethnic composition of Belgium. This is very important. Always questions asked from this topic. Share power to minimize the chances of conflicts. Community government was created through constitutional amendments. Belgium had now, after the amendment, after the bringing new form of government, community government, now Belgium had three levels of government, central, state and community. There was equal representation in all the linguistic groups to minimize chances of conflicts. Thank you very much.